Thank you, Senator Manchin. Thank you, gentlemen, for your testimony today. General McMaster, we've talked about a lot of kind of new types of competition with China. Let's talk about a very old-fashioned hard power question about China. How bad would it be for America's security and our national interests if China went for the jugular in Taiwan, if China invaded and annexed Taiwan to the mainland?
Okay, Senator, I would just say, first of all, that, you know, if we were to respond, and the costs on China would be tremendous as well. I think there's a race ongoing right now to help Taiwan harden its defenses, to make itself indigestible prior to the period of, I think, which is of greatest danger, which is from 2022 onwards, based on the conclusion of the Beijing Winter Olympics and based on the Communist Party Congress. I think that the key thing is to work with the Taiwanese armed forces, us and others, like-minded countries, to help them strengthen their defenses and to support the policies that President, reforms that President Tsai Ing-wen has initiated. But it would be extremely costly for both sides. If the United States did decide to respond to Taiwan, I do believe that the People's Liberation Army would suffer tremendous losses based on the tremendous capabilities of our joint forces. The important point that I would make, though, is it's immensely important to keep forward position capable joint forces there, because what China's trying to do is to create in the South China Sea a barrier that would make it just far too costly for us to come to any allies' defense. This is vis-a-vis Taiwan, but it's also in their effort to isolate China's major regional competitor, Japan, as well.
And one of those new types of competition is in advanced technology. If China were able to invade and annex Taiwan, it would also put in Chinese hands the world's leading producer of semiconductor chips as well.
Absolutely. And if you look at geostrategic implications, if you just turn the map sideways, such that Taiwan is on the front, and you see how that gives the People's Liberation Army tremendous access to coerce others in the region.
One final question on this, and I'd like to address it to both of you. It was long U.S. policy that we would maintain a position of strategic ambiguity about supporting Taiwan should China invade it. Some experts, to include Richard Haass, president of the Council of Foreign Relations, has said that we should replace that now with a policy of strategic clarity, because China's military is so much stronger, because it's specifically geared increasingly towards an invasion of Taiwan, because Taiwan has developed a strong, robust democratic culture, that it wouldn't be a change of the end state we're trying to achieve, which is the maintenance of peace in the Western Pacific. It'd simply be a change of the policy means to achieve that end state by going from strategic ambiguity, being unclear to the world, to Beijing, to Taipei about what the U.S. to do, to one of strategic clarity that said simply, we will come to Taiwan's aid should China invade Taiwan. General McMaster, do you believe that strategic clarity would be the right policy for the United States?
No, I do not. I believe the strategic ambiguity is adequate, especially after we've made public the six assurances to Taiwan. And I think if we act in the way that the Trump administration has acted and the new Biden administration has acted to assure Taiwan and to send a pretty clear message to China. And I think the message to China ought to be, hey, you can assume that the United States won't respond. But that was the assumption made in June of 1950 as well, when North Korea invaded South Korea. So I think it's really by our actions rather than our words. And of course, I know it would strike home to all of you that this is an Article I issue, right, to go to war or to not go to war. So I think it would be appropriate to maintain strategic ambiguity, and if that crisis occurs, I'm sure that all of you and your colleagues would reflect the will of the American people on what we do about it.
Dr. Wright.
Yeah, I fully agree with General McMaster. I think I wouldn't revisit the concept of strategic ambiguity, but I think through actions we can demonstrate and deter this action and demonstrate U.S. commitment and a stronger and closer relationship with Taiwan.
Thank you both, gentlemen. I must confess, sitting here behind the Senator Manchin nameplate, I'm tempted to announce the way the most powerful senator in Washington is going to vote on all Biden administration nominations and legislation. But I won't, out of a show of gratitude that Senator Manchin allowed me to borrow his microphone. Thank you, Senator Manchin.